A lot of professors require that for research you use something called a scholarly journal. They also might refer to it as an academic journal or a peer review journal. Why are they so important? Well, this is the publications that experts on subjects do. Experts are people who have master's degrees, PhDs, or doctorates. They're typically your professors and doctors. What they do is that they conduct their own research, depending on the field, and they write an article that includes the literature review, what you do when you write a paper, and their own research. The reason it's called peer review is that the process it goes for editing is done by the expert's peers. So you have on a journal a panel of experts who will read an author's article. They too are experts in their field, and they go back and forth with editing, not just the copy editing, the spelling and grammar, and the fact-checking, but also the confirmation that the research conclusions and methods are valid. And if the board, the panel, the peers, do not agree with the author and they can't make it work, then it doesn't get published. And this can take months to get done. Specific ways to identify a peer review article. And to do so requires that you actually look at the article sometimes. First, you want to see the author's information. This means who they are, their degrees, where they work, and maybe even an email address for them. Second, you want to look for citations at the end of the articles. This is not simply a torture device for you when you write papers. This is actually part of the entire academic process. It's the chain that connects article to article and shows the value of an article and the research done. You'll notice, third, that there are no ads, there are no photos, no color, graphic, really. There might be images, but it'll primarily be graphs and charts. And last, you'll see some sort of database identification when you're in the database looking at the article. It might say peer-reviewed, scholarly peer-reviewed, or something similar. Here's an example of what is a scholarly peer-reviewed article. You can see the front page, and we're going to look at elements of it in the next few slides that can help you identify more specific elements of it. But this is what the first page would look like for a scholarly article. Notice it's kind of plain, a lot of text. A closer look at that front page, you can see the journal information at the very top, including the article's title and then the two authors and where they're from. Following that is a paragraph summary of the article with some keywords included. The summary is just to give you an idea of what this article is about. It's not actually content that you can quote. So use it to help you get an idea of the value of this article to your paper, but don't use it as sources of information. Use the rest of the article. On a further page in the article, there's something like this, a table. There are no graphics, no pictures, nothing glossy and pretty and colorful. This is the kind of image you get in a scholarly article, a table of the data that they had. And finally, like you, authors of peer-reviewed and scholarly and academic articles have to create a bibliography, a list of the references they used. This is, again, not just a way for us to torture you and make your paper writing life difficult. This is you participating in what we all do. We all create a list of references. This is just a small excerpt from the bibliography of this article. It actually went on for two more pages after this. But you get a sense that you're not alone in doing this, that even when we are experts in our field, we put the sources we use, and it's a sign of the quality of the article by showing these sources. Let's compare this to a trade publication. Now, a trade publication is typically written for people in a field, but the articles in it tend to be a little nicer looking and not going through the peer review process, so they don't have the same requirements. Here's the cover, the first page of an article from a trade publication on body language. You can see the name of the article and the name of the author, and a really bold, colorful graphic behind it. Trade publications are typically laid out the way a traditional magazine is laid out. So there's images, advertisements, it's a glossier, it's more colorful. You can see here an excerpt from one of the pages that we have quotes pulled out from the article and made bolder and stylized, including an ad at the bottom of the page. The last page of the article, you can see here there's some bullet points, it's text heavy, but what you can see on the far right column is actually at the very end a way to contact the people who were interviewed and the author's information. Now, the author is an expert in the field, but you notice there's no bibliography, there's no methodology. This is an informational article. Therefore, it's not peer reviewed. Even when these articles show up in what is considered a scholarly or peer-reviewed journal, the article itself is what's important. If that's not peer-reviewed, you can't consider it peer-reviewed. And when it doesn't have a bibliography or some indication that the article itself is peer-reviewed, you want to skip it until you know you have the peer-reviewed requirement met for your paper. So this article is considered a trade publication, therefore popular literature, and is not to be used as a scholarly article, even though an expert is the author. If we compare that to something like People magazine, which is the true popular publication, you can see it's even different from a trade publication. So again, on this idea of body image, eating disorders, that the other two articles have followed with, you can see that this is discussing a very specific television show, something controversial about it. It's glossy, it's attractive to look at, there's colors, there's people. But there's nothing about their methodology, their research, the author's affiliation. Even on the last page, it's not something scholarly. You can see at the very end of the actual article, there's a list of people who wrote this, but they're not scholars, they're not researchers or academics or doctors. They're journalists. They write this article for People magazine. So again, while it might be informative and it might be helpful for your paper, it fits in the realm of popular literature as opposed to scholarly literature. People magazine will never have a peer-reviewed article in it, so you can pretty much count on People magazine to be considered popular. The gray area are those trade publications and things within scholarly journals that aren't necessarily peer-reviewed articles. You want to keep a close eye on all of this. And when in doubt, ask a librarian. We can easily help you identify if it's peer-reviewed or not.